You're listening to KELF, North Pole.
Welcome to Millennial Santa, broadcasting from KELF, the North Pole's radio station. I'm Sunny the Elf, and here's Santa Claus.
Hi, Sunny.
Hey, Santa. You know, I saw you outside polishing your sleigh. Don't the elves usually help you with that?
Oh, yes, they do. But I like to get out there every so often and personally wax it myself. Gives me a little exercise. Also, I think it makes my sleigh go a little faster.
Oh, that reminds me of a message we got from Nico. Nico asks, my friends and I went sledding the other day, and we were going super fast down the hills. How fast is your sleigh, Santa?
Nico, you know, that question has been asked by a lot of people, and there have been many scientists and mathematicians that have tried to figure that out. You know, they estimate how fast I go, but, you know, they say that in order to deliver all the presents within the 37 hours that I have to do it, that my sleigh has to be traveling at 650 miles per second. That is 3,000 times the speed of sound. And that's probably faster than any man-made device on Earth. Plus, the fact is I know, and they tell me the same thing, that my reindeer can only run about 15 miles an hour. They may be smart, all these scientists and mathematicians, but what they fail to realize is that it's not the speed that allows me to make my rounds, but the gravitational wave effect. That moves faster than light. And also I used a little bit of the space-time continuum. Now, those may be big words, but you remember them and Google them, and you'll be surprised by some of the answers. Simply put, I use holes in time to move from one location to another. And this was made possible by Albert Einstein and Tesla's theory on relativity. And they also talked a little bit about the space-time continuum. So basically, you know, I'll go up here at the North Pole, we have a hole, and it's a gravitational hole, and when I enter it with a sleigh, then I can show up on the other side wherever I want to go, and we have different locations. Actually, it's very similar to our distribution points that we have. They're all top secret, and this is all made possible by the fact that we are on top of the world at the North Pole. That's where all the gravity around the world comes to us, at the very top. That's why if you ever pick up a compass, you'll notice that the arrow points north. That's because that's the strongest gravitational area. So that's where our gravitational hole is, right up there on top. I know this is really confusing, and I don't know how young you are, but Google it. It's kind of funny. We get a laugh every so often when I hear the scientists say, well, it's not possible for Santa to do that because he's got to be traveling this fast. And I go, man, I can't go that fast. And the reindeer definitely can't go that fast. So I hope that kind of answers your question. You may have to do some more research, Nico, but that's basically how it happens. Thanks for calling.
Thank you, Nico. If you have a question for Santa or you just want to say hi, we would love to hear from you. You can send us a voicemail or text us here at the radio station. The number is 304-745-0870. You can also find us on WhatsApp. Kids, be sure to get your parents' permission first. All right, bye guys. Bye, Santa.
Bye now, and remember, keep the spirit of Christmas alive in your heart throughout the year.
Millennial Santa is a proud member of Parents on Demand, a network of high-quality podcasts for families just like yours. Download our free network app on Apple and Android and listen to your favorite episodes on the go, just like Santa.